Hey there, Stan the Medical Minuteman here, back with your weekly Medical Minute Monday. To better prepare for the flu season, we're discussing rapid influenza tests today. When diagnosing the cause of a disease, I think we'd all agree that earlier is better. Rapid influenza detection tests, or RIDTs, are tests that, well, rapidly detect influenza. These are antigen detection assays similar to rapid strep tests, and they typically yield results in 10 to 30 minutes. Some RIDTs are even cleared for bedside use, which means that access to a laboratory is not needed. The best method for collecting a sample is usually a nasal aspirate, which is when saline is injected into the nostril and then suctioned out. Nasal swabs and throat swabs are faster, easier, and more comfortable for the patient, so they're more common. They are more effective combined in the same specimen than they are alone, so you might see a nasal and throat swab taken together. Fast, minimally invasive, and accessible. These tests sound great, so why do we still have slower tests available? Rarely do we see an increase in speed without some form of cost, and RIDTs are no exception. The first disadvantage is that some RIDTs don't differentiate between influenza A and B, and none of them detect influenza C. Fortunately, most RIDTs will differentiate between influenza A and B, and the inability to test for influenza C isn't a major concern because this strain usually causes mild symptoms and doesn't result in epidemics. The second disadvantage is specific to influenza A. Influenza A has hundreds of subtypes, such as H1N1, but an RIDT won't tell you what subtype the patient has. Lastly, and perhaps the most significant disadvantage of RIDTs, is that they have suboptimal test sensitivity. This means that false negatives are common, especially when influenza activity is high. False positives are less likely, but still occur, especially when influenza activity is low. The big picture, RIDTs are convenient, fast, and especially beneficial to clinicians working in remote areas where advanced techniques are not readily available. However, they have a higher chance of false negatives and positives. Some provide incomplete information regarding the influenza strain, and no information regarding the influenza A subtype is provided. With this in mind, don't be surprised to see your clinician prescribe antivirals to treat influenza despite a negative RIDT. This is especially true if influenza is prevalent in your community. I hope you enjoyed this week's Medical Minute Monday. Now you know a thing or two about rapid influenza diagnostic tests, but how are you with antipyretics? Fever is often seen with influenza, so be sure to check out our Antipyretics Medical Minute. Do you want to see more influenza-related medical minutes? Let me know by leaving a comment below. I'll see you all next Monday for a review of fundoscopy. And for more updates like these, come join us online.